alive is alive.
Oh yeah. Whoa, 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 whoa. Today we are going to sing a new song to the Almighty God of Israel. Wow, I'm so excited this morning. I'm so elated, honestly. And I'm sure you are all the same, you know, as me. We are all happy to be here. It's the Resurrection Sunday. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. On behalf of, Daddy Glen and Mommy Lou, I'd like to say happy Easter Sunday to everyone on site, online, and to our Kenya family. You know, I'll say happy, blessed Easter to all of you. If you're visiting us for the very first time, I'd like you to know our name. This is Faith Dimensions Ministries, where Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Yes, last Friday, Jesus went to Calvary, right? To save the wretch like you and I. But the story didn't end here. Today, he resurrected with all power in his hands. With all power in his hands. Therefore, I would like to say Mazel Tov, which means, that's a Jewish word for congratulations, that we are all here to celebrate our King, to hail our King, to exalt him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Have you got your dancing shoes on today? Because I'm gonna dance. My husband is going to pray. Hallelujah.
Good morning, Father.
Oh, hallelujah.
Good morning, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this day.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. We praise your holy name. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege and honor to be counted among the living. As we celebrate this special day, Resurrection Sunday, we thank you. We bless you, O Lord. We praise your holy name. We thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross for our sake and for rising because we are people of hope. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Father, Lord. We thank you, O God, for this special occasion, O God. Father, Lord, we commit this service into your hands, O Lord. It's all about you, Lord. Let only you be heard. Let only you be seen today, O God. As we celebrate, as we worship you, O God, let it be in spirit and in truth, O Lord. Father, Lord, let your spirit that raised Jesus from the dead raise up, O God, our mortal bodies today, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. We pray that let your spirit, O God, move in this place today, O God. Let faith arise. Let peace arise. Let healing arise today, O God. Let there be deliverance today, O God. Father, Lord, we commit it, O God, this day to your hands, O God. As we celebrate you, God, let there be transformation. Let there be healings, O God. This is a brand new day, a new season, O God. Let your name be glorified, O God. Let us not live here the same way we've come, O God. That at the end of the day, your name and your name alone shall be glorified now and forevermore.
Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Will you turn to your neighbor and tell him, my God is not dead. You know, on Friday we were talking about Sunday, right? Now Sunday is here. Sunday, there's a song that says, when Sunday comes. Now Sunday is here. Turn to your other neighbor, tell him, my God is not dead. In fact, pull them by the hand. Pull them. Tell them, my God is not dead. He's still alive. Still alive. He's still alive. Clap your hands. Come on. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. Clap your hands.
He's still alive, God's not dead. of the mansion. Say, let the heavens hear you. I can feel him in my feet. I can feel him. Direct, but it's a bank holiday tomorrow. Hallelujah. Woo. Let's do it because of the bishop. Amen. We'll pace ourselves because of you. Hallelujah. Because we know something dangerous is coming. Something dangerous. Woo. What a beautiful name. The Bible says, wherefore God. You know, after Jesus went through all of this, died on the cross like we were so eloquently taught on Friday, then the Bible says he descended into hell. Wow. And he took from the devil the keys of death, the keys of hell, the keys of the grave. So now we're no longer afraid of dying, because we cannot die. Death is but a door. Hallelujah. And the Bible says when he came up from the grave, he led captivity captive. He made an open show of the devil, triumphing over the devil. And he gave gifts unto men. And one of those gifts is the name Jesus. The Bible says God has exalted him and given him a name above every other name. That at the name of Jesus, doesn't matter what it is, cancer will bow, depression will bow, confusion will bow, the devil will bow, the world will bow, because we have a name. Oh, oh, oh. Hey. Oh. You one with God, the Lord knows the hidden glory in creation, God, now revealed in you, my Christ. And what a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name.
Oh, the name.
may trust in horses. Some may trust in chariots. But we will remember the name of the Lord our God. Your name is as ointment poured forth. That's why we love you, Jesus. Your name, your name, your name, your name, your name. At the mention of your name, Jesus. Oh, Rabakashatala Bakanda.
Praise the Lord. Yes, Lord. All praise is due to your name, O God. You are worthy of all the praise, worthy of all the glory, worthy of all the honor. We come today, God, to praise you, to exalt you, and to magnify you. For you are the King of Kings and you are the Lord of Lords. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Our God has no equals. He has no rivals. He is just the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. He's God all by himself. Hallelujah. And it's good to be in the house of the Lord today. Amen. How many of you are glad to be in the house of the Lord today? That's 10 of you. How many of you are glad to be in the house of the Lord today? Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. As I was standing there, the Spirit of God was just speaking to me and saying, there's no coincidence that today is the 31st of March. It's the last day of this month, of March. So we finished the first quarter and we're going into the second quarter. So I believe today, if you set your sail right, if you get your mind in the right place where it needs to be, if you get your heart where it needs to be, everything is lined up for something new to happen today. Hallelujah. Everything is lined up that we can turn a page today. Today, something is going to end and something new is going to commence, because tomorrow is the 1st of April. It's the beginning of a new series. Something new is going to happen, amen? But it starts today. I believe something's going to happen today. I don't know. The water has been troubled over the month of prayer. Something has been happening in this church. Something is changing. If you're ready for a change, how many of you are ready for a change? How many of you are ready for a change? The change starts today. I believe the change, Bishop, it starts something awesome. The table is spread. The table is ready for us to take on something new today. We are not going to continue the way how we've been. Brother Ola, we are not going to continue the way how it's been. There's going to be a change today. There is going to be a change today. I don't know who that's for. Maybe I'm speaking for myself. Something is going to change today. Hallelujah. 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 My God, I feel it, Bishop. Something's going to change today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God. My God. Something is going to change today. And I'm happy about it. I'm happy about it. Something's going to change today. My God, my God, my God, my God. Hallelujah. 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 For the Bible says, we're getting ready to sow a seed. The Bible says, for God so loved the world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him. Do I have any believers in the house today? You and I shall not perish, but we shall have what? Everlasting life. So this life that we're living is not just about the physical. There is a spiritual element to the life that we're living. And God has set us up for something great. But we've got to believe it and we've got to appropriate it by this one thing, faith. The life that God wants us to live, we've got to appropriate it by faith. So I don't care what you're going through. I don't care what your circumstances. Today, something new is about to happen. Amen. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, it doesn't matter who you are, it doesn't matter if you're black, white, if you're young, or whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but have what? Everlasting life. Amen. And God shows us it started with him. He gave. So right now we're going to give our offering and sow our seed. In Jesus' name, God bless you.
Hallelujah. Our Savior is alive. He is the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. He wears the victor's crown. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
No one can.
Victory belongs.
Victory belongs.
It belongs.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. The victory belongs to you. Father God, let us pray. We thank you that we can be in your presence today, Father God. Some have come from near, some have come from far, Father God. But thank you for your protection, your journeys, mercies, that we can be in your house today, Father God. The last day of this month, Father God. Thank you, God, for giving your Son, that we can believe in him and we can have everlasting life, Father God. Thank you for the giving to us, oh God. Now, King Jesus, we've just given back a portion of what you've given unto us. So, Lord God, bless the seed that's been sown, Father God. Multiply it, Father God. Bless the hands of the givers and those who haven't been able to give. Bless them also that they'll be able to give in the future. Now, King Jesus, take control of the rest of this service. Have your way. Let your kingdom come. Let your kingdom be obvious in this place. Let your power be in this room, Father God. And let lives be changed today. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Lord, what an awesome praise and worship. My God, you could just feel the atmosphere changing. God is in the room, amen? Praise God, okay? Praise God. But just before the choir comes, just got just a few announcements to give to you. Okay, just a reminder that our 11 a.m. service is streamed on Facebook, it's on YouTube, and it's also on our website. So our services are streamed on Facebook, YouTube, and also on the Faith Dimensions website. Amen? Right, okay, some dates for your diary because April is fast approaching. So, ladies, you've got your meeting on the 6th of April. So, ladies, you've got your ladies' meeting right here on the 6th of April at 9:30. Men, we've got our men's breakfast on the 13th of April at 9:30, which will be upstairs in the restaurant. Okay, and then the following Saturday, ladies, you've got your Pilates, is that the right word? Pilates. Sash, what are you laughing for? It's Pilates, isn't it? You've got your stretching exercises. Is that what you do? I don't know. Okay, anyway, you've got your Pilates on the 20th of April. And that's actually going to be upstairs in the restaurant. That's at 10 a.m. So 20th of April, 10 a.m. in the restaurant. £5 payment to be given to PJ no later than Sunday, the 14th of April. Okay. And then we've got our autumn ball. Woohoo, indeed. We've got our autumn ball. Deposits are going to be due on the 14th of April. So the deposits are due 14th of April. And please see Abby Bademosi with your payments. Amen? Right, okay. Okay, we're going to leave the birthdays till afterwards. Right. Adiola, are we all set? He's walking off. All set, yeah? Right, choir, are you ready? I think the choir is ready. Brother Ade, are you ready? You're ready. Let it feel welcome as I come, Faith Dimensions Choir. Let it feel welcome. Put your hands together.
He's alive. I'm not a person that likes parties like that, but I'll make an exception today. He's alive. The tomb is empty. Remaining. He got up fully. The only thing left there is napkin. But he is alive. Woo! And you see, he didn't just get up. The Bible says that he rose with all power. If he runs with all power, then there's no other power left that is in any other person, but in the name of Jesus, because he runs with all power. So, the devil cannot scare me, because Jesus has all power. If he has all power, then the devil has no power. My boss cannot harass me, because he doesn't have any power, because Jesus has
all power.
Sickness cannot harass my body, because it doesn't have any power, but Jesus has
all power.
Death cannot intimidate me, because it has no power. Jesus has
all power.
I dare you to tell your situation this morning that you don't have any power, because my God has
thank you.
Hallelujah. Let's give it up for FDM choir. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Hallelujah. Awesome, awesome. Is that like they're going from glory to glory? Amen. My God, my God, my God. Praise you, Jesus. Amen, amen. Praise God. Okay. At this point, we've got a few birthdays to celebrate. My goodness. I'm really happy to be saying that today is Brother Elijah Bader's birthday. Some know him as Timmy. It's his birthday today. And if you know, hallelujah, to God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Hallelujah, 27 today. I was just speaking to his mom, and she made me laugh. She said she didn't know what to do with herself today. She didn't know what to praise or to dance or to jump or to skip. Oh, my God. Sister Abby? Oh, my God. Sister Ade, we rejoice with you today, ma'am. We rejoice with you today. Just do what you have to do. Hallelujah. And Brother Timmy, I know you're not here. I know you're abroad. Happy birthday to you, sir. We're really happy to celebrate your birthday today. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Sister Eleanor, it's your birthday tomorrow, ma'am. Happy birthday to you. God, there's a few birthdays, actually. Follow Jimmy. I can see you. It's your birthday on Tuesday. Nathaniel, I don't know where he is. Adaro, it's your birthday on Tuesday. I can see you. Praise God. How old is that now? How old is that? 13. A teenager. Brother Oscar. Sister Lorna, teenager. Oh, my goodness. Okay. Right. Okay, we haven't finished. Carl Bonsu. Carl, I don't know where you are. Happy birthday for Friday. And Sister June, it's also your birthday on Friday. Praise God. Happy birthday to you all. Celebrate and have a great time as you celebrate another year. Amen? My God. Okay, we've also got an anniversary. It's a special anniversary. Elder George and Sister Gloria. This is what 20 years looks like. 20th anniversary, we celebrate with you. I'm still smiling. Brother George, you're doing something right, sir. Both of you. It's a team effort, isn't it? Team effort. To God be the glory. Right, what? Okay, that's better. That's better. That's better. Come on, can we please stand to our feet? Can everybody stand to their feet, please? Praise God. We're going to pray for this dear couple. Praise God. Let us pray together for their union, 20 years together, and many, many more. Let's pray together. Thank you, Lord God. Amen, amen, amen. Bless you guys. Bless you guys. Bless you. Bless you. Praise God. At this time, we've got a treat. Sister Ella is going to come and sing for us. Let her feel welcome as she comes. Let her feel welcome. Come on, you can do better than that. Okay, just before you come, just hold it right there. I believe Sister Sam's gonna come. Let her feel welcome.
This morning, I think it's the first time since I'm in the church you see me in this position. And the reason why is because the seniors, we have some people here called the seniors. You may not know each and every one of us, but most of us are always here. We have a band leader, a senior leader. And she's been very good to us over the number of years since she's been leader. And because of her illness, she didn't able to do what she used to do during the years, which she used to take us out for dinner, have meeting upstairs to discuss different things, and have meeting at the back of this century. And all of that stopped because there's something that called not feeling good, not able to, cannot do it anymore, so we have to just give up. But this morning we're here as the seniors. Four of us are not here, but whatever we plan to do and we told them, they contribute. So today we want to say thank you, seniors, for every one of you who know you've been faithful to your God. I want to leave three scriptures with you. I'm not going to read them all. I want you, when you have time, to read them. You know why? Because we was once young. But now we are old, but we have never seen the righteous forsaken, nor the seed fed in bread. Read it in your own time, because you're young now, but we was once there. Yes. Now the verse I would like to leave with you is Psalms 23 and verse 5 and 6. Thou preparest a table before us in the presence of our enemies, not our loved ones, our enemies. And because of that, the days of our years are 70 years and 10. So while we're alive and we can do what we can do or what he has called us to do, do it as unto him. Amen. Not unto man, or unto God. Amen. Amen. God bless you. I would like if Sister Glory and Brother Aki, Brother Lawrence could come up here, please, if they don't mind. On the behalf of the seniors, we decided to show our love to you. We know that during the years, you couldn't do it anymore, but on Christmas, you never forget us. You never forget us on Christmas, every one of us. You give us a special gift, a special gift. And we're grateful to you. So just in return, we just delight to say thank you. And may God bless you for your hard work. Thank you. To say this up front, Pastor and Sister Lu, thank you for the opportunity to stand around your holy book. I feel honored, sir. Thank you.
Love you, Mom. Thank you. Oh my, come on. Let's give it up for Sister Sam. Come on. Dear lady. It's difficult. There's some people who do stuff in secret I don't even know about. I can remember when we first came to this church, and I think it was later on, dear Sister Sam actually used to buy our children's school uniform, shirts and so forth. This is a dear lady, and you don't see her looking for any accolades or anything like that. Come on, let's give it up for Sister Sam. Come on. Dear lady, woman of God. Praise God. We thank God for your life. May he give you many, many more happy years. Amen. Praise God. One more time for Sister Sam. Come on, one more time. Praise God. Okay, Sister Lou, are you ready? Oh God. Let's ask for strength for our dear lady and our bishop when he comes. Come on, let's give it together. Put our hands together for her. Praise God.
My mama. remember the time when she used to tower over me. And now I can almost pick her up like a little dolly. But she is an amazing lady. You know, she may not be able to. We had to retire her from the ushering team. And she retired herself from the choir. But I want to bless God for her servitude, seen and unseen. And in fact, more so unseen. So one more time, please, just bless Sister Sam. Brother Lawrence, Sister Gloria, again, we bless you for your labor of love over the years. And we thank God that you have been able to do what you do. And may God continue to strengthen and give you the fortitude to continue to run your race in the name of Jesus. Please just take your seats one more time for just for a moment. I'd like the following just to stand. Today's Easter Sunday. And Ola, you didn't need to sing that song, but bless you for singing the song. For me, you could have just sung the first song and just carried on saying hallelujah, praise the Lord, because God was all over this place. But thank you for protocol, we know, but sometimes we just need to ditch protocol and just follow what God is doing. Amen. But isn't there an anointing in the house this morning? And we really do thank God for his presence in our lives. It's good to see everybody in the house this morning. I see some friends from new and old, and it's just good to see everybody. If you just sit in next to somebody, not your partner, just turn around and just say, good to see you on Easter Sunday. Don't move out your seats. Good to see you on Easter Sunday. Praise the Lord. And as we was told on Friday, and it was reiterated this morning, we were reminded that he's been given a name above every name. So whatever that thing is, it's got a name. And we praise God that his name is above that name this morning. Sister Sam, will you stand? Sister Shirley, will you stand? Mike Compton, will you stand? Roger and Marie Baker, will you stand? Brother Joan and Sister Neville is not with us this morning, but Val, can you stand on behalf of Mom and Dad? Brother Herbie, will you stand? Rosemary, will you stand? And Sister Chambers, will you stand? We as a church have got a little gift for you. You might need to take it. If they can't manage to, please pass it down. This is just a little hamper, an Easter hamper for you all, just to say that we love you, we appreciate you. And may God continue to strengthen you all. As you get your hamper, you may be seated. Put your hands together. Please bless our amazing seniors. Come on, keep blessing them until they're all seated. We have one on the baptistry, and we have one. You young people need to be running like Usain Bolt. Praise the Lord. I know some of you are that age, but you're not ready to be in that group. That's all I'm saying. Some of you are at that age. But the funny thing about it is, when we give out gifts, they say, where's my gift? Sign yourself up to the seniors group. So those of you who want gifts and the blessings and taken out to dinner, sign yourself up. Praise the Lord. I'm not there yet, so don't even look at me. Praise the Lord. Seniors, we love you, and we thank God for keeping you. And may he continue to keep you. Praise the Lord. Amen. At this time, while you settle yourselves, Sister Ruby, praise Lord. Ella, are you around, Ella? Come, sweetheart. This amazing young lady is going to minister to us this morning. And can I just also say, we will be having Lord's Supper, and you will be asked, on those of you on the balcony who will want to participate in the Lord's Supper, you will be asked to come down. So once it's announced, please can you just respectfully make your way down and stand at the door, and the ushers and the coordinators will direct you in accordingly. Please, one more time, give this wonderful young lady a round of applause.
give your God a wave offering this afternoon. Come on. Just wave at your God. Just wave at him. Come on. And just worship him for a few minutes. Come on. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Surely he is Yeshua. Yeah. Well, put your hands together and bless this young lady. What a gift. Hello, you're amazing, young lady. Thank you, God. Thank you. Come on, come on. Bless the gift. Bless the gift. Thank God for the gift. Thank you, Lord. You know, it's our emotions are very, it's a very strange thing. I've studied my own emotions over the years, and having to grapple with various ranges of emotions and still having to do your duty as the house demands, as the ministry, as a call demands. And I kind of felt this morning was going to be different, but I didn't realize how different it was going to be, because we started as we should do with high praise, and man, did the band and the worship team not tear up the house this morning. Did a fantastic job. Fantastic job, as usual. But this morning, just excellent. Then, of course, the choir, of course, does what the choir does. Thank you, Jesus. Bless God for our choir and the worship team this morning. And then, Mom stood up. She said, the first time doing this. And then the Bible says, you know, what is man? And as this frail lady walked up here, I reflected, Mom. I remember the first day I walked into your house. Very first day. It was a Thursday. Thursday evening, I lived in Reading, they lived in Slough. Okay, and I walked in that house and I demanded, just took over this lady's life, didn't ask her permission at all. Just knew she was going to be mine, just pronounced it. And this woman just opened the door and accepted this crazy bloke into her life. And in the 47 years I've known this, yes, amazing lady. Her life has not been easy at all. I'm a connoisseur of life. Although I was in the family, I wasn't in the family as a stranger. So there was a demarcation line I didn't really want to cross, but I watched the family as I became integral to the family. And I thought about your life, Mum. And thought about this gift you've given to me. But a few weeks ago, I stood in this very spot, and I mentioned that, and this is not really that Easter service, really, it's a thing to say, but that statement I made here, which was you want to sit down for a minute or two, that statement I made about the appointment, remember that statement? Do you want that statement? And she is not dead, thank God, but it's pretty obvious she's elderly, she's frail. My sister G, and thank you, Mom, for honoring G, and Lawrence. It wasn't just G, it was Lawrence as well. Both of them took care of the seniors for us for a while, and now that's superseded. We now have, we're building the welfare team, which will take that over, but Ade's edited that, and very prudent move. And I just thought about life.
47 years in this family, and still going strong. But the reality is, not only is she getting older, so are all of us. Okay? And none of you in this room, including myself, can guarantee that you live to see her age. None of you. It's an amazing thing, this thing called life. Nobody knows the length that you've been given. But I looked across my own family. I saw my sister run out. I know why you ran out of the room. And it's next week, we say farewell to my elder brother. Next week. And you cannot imagine having to deal with all these range of emotions. But God has helped us. But Mom, we thank God for your life. Okay? And I pray that God will strengthen you and your senior years. That God will strengthen you, Mom. Okay? That God will strengthen you. Okay? Because when the body is frail, the things that your mind wants to do, you can no longer do. But thank God for this amazing lady. Thank you. Come on, thank God for this amazing lady. So it's that kind of more. I'm fighting my own emotions, not to give way to my emotions. And when Norma ran out of the room, I just thought, my God. I looked at my junior sister there, G over there. She's not well. Lawrence, the senior man, the ravage of time and the toll it takes on all of us. But here's the thing, brothers and sisters. I will say this. No, I don't say it as much as I used to, but I will say it again. While you have life, live it. Okay? While you have life, live it. Young people, live your life, okay? And don't put off your today is for tomorrow, because you don't know what tomorrow holds for you. And the amazing thing about tomorrows is that the one thing I've discovered about this thing called life, things happen to you no matter how spiritual you are. Things will happen to you, okay? And your body sometimes, unfortunately, will be affected by life. Sickness will get all of you, but we have the ability through God to cast them out in Jesus' name. But you will have occasions where you have to understand that bad things happen to good people. And because you're a child of a living God, doesn't exempt you from pain. I will tell you that now. Sometimes the more you commit yourself to God, the more pain you have to go through. Because we're in a fallen world and the devil hates the believers. But thank God for the grace of God. Please say amen right there. Thank God for the grace of God. Brother Tosin and his family just came back last week from saying farewell to their father in Nigeria. And I watch you guys. I know what you feel. Okay? I've been there at least four times now. Because we say goodbye to staff next week. That's the fourth one. Dad, Mom. Excuse me? Yeah. Dad, Mom, my elder brother, my eldest brother, and my second eldest brother. Four times. So I know what this thing does to you. And at these moments, we've got to make up our minds about what we believe and trust God that somehow that He will help us. And we will not die before our due time. Amen. Not die before our due time. We'll fulfill our allotted days. There are two things that the Spirit of God deals with me very strangely. A lot of times God deals with me when I'm in my shower and sometimes when I'm in my devotion. Even before I was in our devotion this morning, there's two things that God said I must do. And he kind of threatened me, you need to do this. And I won't tell you what he said, but he said, you need to do this. This may sound strange to you. But as God's my witness, God told me this morning to pray for those who gave to the ministry today. Pray for those who gave to the ministry today. Okay? And I was going to ring you, and Eldon says, because I kind of felt it was your turn to do this morning. I will do the offering. Right where you are, I will not fail this assignment. God said, pray for those who gave today. That's the first thing he says. The second thing God says, and this is why I kind of knew this service was going to go out of my control, because I'm a preaching machine. I came ready to preach, but that doesn't. I am not going to preach this morning, okay? Because we must take the Eucharist. We must. I want you to listen to these words. This is the last day of the month of Abib. Am I right? We have tracked the history of the meaning of this word, Abib. Nehemiah calls it the month of Nisan, the month of miracles. And we've tracked that and we've followed this sequence for many years, at least 10 years. The whole month has been given to prayer. And I just feel that this particular year is different. Okay? Because we do things, and one of the things I am very afraid of is rituals. I don't like things that's just done ritualistically. And I question things a lot in terms of what we do in church. Okay? Like conferences, convocations, and these things. Why do we do these things? We know why the Israelites did it, but why do we do it? And you know, sometimes I just don't do it. For example, this year we're not having a conference. I just decided that we're not going to have a conference. We're going to have something, but not a conference this year. I had planned one, but God says, don't have a conference. But we will have a day of celebration. Okay? But we're not going to have a conference per se. Please just help me to flow with what God tells me, because first of all, it'd be good for the church bank balance anyway. It'd be good not to have a conference, but that's not the reason. The reason is because I just don't feel the oil on the conference this year. But I do feel the oil flowing for a day of celebration, okay? Because this is still our year of domination. I will tell you this much. In 38 years of ministry, without question, this has been the hardest year of my life. Without question. I've seen some things, but this year has by far been the hardest year of my life. And I am here today because of the sovereignty of God. Okay? And I thank God for His grace. What this year has taught me is how to lean on the Holy Ghost. Not on flesh. On the Holy Ghost. This year. That surprised you, right? But understand that the purposes of God often takes you through very, very dark places. 2.5 years ago, Psalm 23 became my psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. I've been taught that prayer from a child, but I didn't really understand it. 2.5 years ago, I fully understood it. The Lord is my shepherd, my shepherd. The king, David, who was a shepherd of Israel, realized that it was God who kept him from his enemies. Had it not been for God, even his own son Absalom would have killed him. But so David says, the Lord is my shepherd. I understand what David meant. The Lord has been your pastor's shepherd. And I want God to do something as we close this chapter in this month called Abib that you have never seen before. You have never seen before. A gentleman walked in here this week. I don't know who he is. Never met him before. And he said some things. And I said to him, we will speak again. And I walked out the room. Because as the man was speaking, God was speaking to me. I think he was a human being, but I've never met him before. He looked a bit like Johnson. A bit more healthy, as they would say in South Africa, but your complexion. He was an Indian. And he said some things, and I thought, my God. All I could say is, we will speak again. And I literally said, give me your card. And I walked out the room. And as I walked in this room this morning, and I looked across the congregation, it's been many years since we've had the church this full on a Sunday. Am I right? There was a time this was normal. Okay? This was normal. We'd have the church full, even the sides were full. And New Year's Eve, we'd have people sitting outside. But when I scanned the congregation, the words of this stranger came back to me. Part of what the man said, he says, this church will be full again. He has never been here. He's never been here. And I thought, what? Why did you say that? The conversation will continue. But let me do what I know I have to do today. We will pray. I will pray for those who gave the offering. Not because I planned to, because God told me to do it. Please stand. Hallelujah. Something happened when Israel came out of Egypt. Israel, by all accounts, was busted, broken economically. They'd lost their identity. They'd given up everything when it came under the control of Pharaoh. But something happened, and please get this, and don't miss what I'm going to tell you. The day that God cornered Pharaoh, finally, after 9 plagues, God said, Moses, tell the people to apply the blood of the lamb to the 2 side posts and the lintel of their house. For I will pass over the land. Tell your neighbor, get ready to come out of this. God did not negotiate. I think I will bring this message to you next week. God did not negotiate with Pharaoh. God said to Moses, tell my people, not the Egyptian, to apply the blood, because something is going to pass through the land of Egypt tonight. In fact, God said the death angel is going to pass through tonight. But when I see the blood, or when he sees the blood, he will pass over you. Jesus. Then the strange thing about this, when Pharaoh experienced the power of Moses as God, he told Moses the same night, get your people. Not tomorrow, tonight. Leave. Leave. After 430 years, get out tonight. But where they were going required wealth, unbeknown to them. And scripture says something very strange, that the Egyptian lent them as much as they had need of. Every time I read that, I smile. Lent them. Suggests it's coming back. But God said, when the death angels pass over Egypt tonight, there'll be death in Egypt. And the Bible testifies from Pharaoh's house, even to the cattle, the firstborn in every house in Egypt died. But all those who had the blood applied, hear that? Not just had the blood, it had to be applied. The death angel did not go and knock the doors of the Israelites and say, I know you have the lamb's blood in the basin in the house. He didn't say that. All he was looking for is the sign that the blood is in that house. And so here's the point. As they left Egypt that night, they left loaded. I think what I'm trying to tell you, or what God is intimating to us today, is that if I will pray as a priest over this house, over the money that was given, God is going to do something special, different. But it's only going to happen for those who gave and those who have been prayed for who gave. If you've sowed today into this house, lift up your hands to the heavens. Lift up your hands to the God who owns the gold and the silver, cat up on 1,000 hills. They don't belong to Pharaoh. They belong to God. And so God, because you instructed me to do this, I applied the blood to heavy raised hands. I applied the blood to the lintels and the doorposts, the 2 doorposts of every house. Father, many things may have died in their lives financially, economically. That's brought separation, great pain, anguish, disappointment. But in the same way you favored Israel as they left with more than enough, Father, they received more than enough. So based on what you instructed me this morning to do, I pray for a more than enough anointing upon every giver. Hallelujah. As they've come to this last day of this incredible month, Father, I pray that tomorrow, Lord, surprise them economically. Overtake them, Father God. Give them a blessing economically that they could never deserve or work for. Father, let the favor of God come upon their money. What they've lost, what's been stolen, what's been hijacked, we command it to return in the name of Jesus. Not even in the same measure, but 100-fold, 1,000-fold, Father God. I pray testimony shall come as a result of this simple prayer that you've asked me to do over this house, Father God. I pray that testimonies will come before we come back next week, Father God, that you will confirm this word in the life of your people. And as you do that, God, they will bless you and testify of the goodness of God, who is able to do far more than able to ask or think, according to that power that's in this room. In the name of Jesus. Please say amen. Please say amen. Please say amen. 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 All right. Be seated one more time. We're going to go into the Eucharist right now. Such an important thing. Jesus said to his followers, unbeknown to them, he said something very strange. He said, I really want to have this meal with you, because after this, we will not eat of this meal until we meet again in my Father's kingdom. Of course, they could not understand what he meant. What I'd planned to say today, and I would, with the permission of God, bring it back to the house next week. Yeah, please, gentlemen, bring it in front of the house. Let them see his table. Let them see his table. The disciples could not and did not understand what Jesus was talking about. They just simply could not understand. Don't forget, their perception of Jesus was the all-conquering mighty God, the one that would overthrow the Roman government and bring liberation to the Jews. That was their perception. He was a promised Messiah. So when he said, with desire, I desire to eat this meal, don't forget, over the 3.5 years they were together, it's of course, they would oftentimes eat fish and bread. Peter's house and by the seashore and various different places. But Jesus was not speaking about fish and bread. The body of Jesus, the bread and the wine, has nothing to do with your physical frame. Nothing. In fact, if you look at it historically, this meal has nothing to do with your taste buds at all. It's not meant to taste good. Okay? At all. But yet Jesus says, above all the meals that we've eaten together, boys, I really, with desire, want to eat this meal with you. Because when we eat this meal, everything I've been to you in the 3.5 years we've been together, this meal will be with you, to you, symbolically, spiritually. Because this is not a physical meal. It's a spiritual meal. I believe our bodies need sustenance from good nourishment, good food. And of course, there's such emphasis on nutrition and the right kind of input and not too much sugar and all these kind of things today, which is important to your physical body. This, however, is crucial for your spiritual well-being and even from a longevity of life. I believe that this bread and this wine can heal us physically. I honestly believe that. I really believe that. With all the travels that we've done, we've traveled all over the world. All over the world. One thing is consistent, whether it be Africa, whether it be India, whether it be South Africa, whether it be Caribbean, America, China, wherever you go on the planet, one thing that's consistent with meal times is bread. Every culture, every continent, bread is part of their staple diet. It really is. Some more than others, but every culture has bread as part of their food. Jesus, however, used that loving, that longing of bread to typify his body. Then his blood. Of course, this what you're going to drink is not alcoholic beverage in any shape or form. It's just grape juice. But it typifies the blood of Jesus. Because every person in this room who has any medical training understand that almost everything about your body, your health, whether it's good or bad, every medical person knows. They can look at the blood and they can tell you if you've got diabetes, cancers, and whatever else may be associated with your ill health. All of it can be seen. Cholesterol, all these things can be seen with a sample of your blood. But the blood of Jesus is very different. What's so different about Brother Jesus? His blood was not conceived from corruption. By that I mean it didn't come from a human being at all. Amen, amen, amen. Joseph was not Jesus' father. God the Father was. And the blood of Jesus is efficacious, all powerful, all healing, all cleansing. To the extent, brothers and sisters, is the divine and demarcation line between death and life. Because when there's sickness in the blood, you need a miracle. Amen. In the blood. So the blood of Jesus, my brothers and sisters, is the one agent as typified with the Jews. It was the blood that brought life. While others were dying, the blood brought salvation and life. Am I right? And so today, in a few minutes, we're going to break this bread and drink this wine. I want you to understand what you're doing. We're not going to take condemnation to ourselves. There's always a kind of trepidation in my heart, a kind of soberness when we come to Lord's Supper. I don't just run up to it and just take it, because this is by far the most expensive of meals ever. It cost God everything. It cost the life of his beloved son. Glory to God. The verse, simple verse says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Brothers and sisters, there's life in the blood. And if you're born again, understand that you have all that is necessary to go to heaven. Because the angel that separates us from heaven and health don't look at you, don't look at your pedigree, don't care. You could be third, fourth, fifth, Pentecostal, doesn't matter. That's not what saves you. What saves you is the fact that you're born again. Well, how? For acceptance of the blood of Jesus that was spilled on Golgotha 2,000 years ago. But that didn't start then. It started nearly 4,000 years ago with what Moses did, the land of Egypt. Everybody say, thank God for the blood. So in this simple act that we're going to do, brothers and sisters, we're coming out of time and space. We're going to the supernatural, and we are going to sit at the table with our master, Emmanuel, Jesus. And his body is going to be broken spiritually. His blood is going to be shed as it was on the cross. When we take it, Jesus says, we do show the Lord's death until he comes. Do you believe Jesus is coming back again? Do you honestly believe it? When he comes again, the world will weep and wail, but we will praise God because we have the ticket that's necessary to go up with him when he comes back. Glory to God. Everybody say, thank God for the blood. So as we sing this, I want you, elders, help me remove these covers. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Please remain in your seat.
Oh, the blood of Jesus.
Of Jesus Christ, and I'm sure all of us was reminded, or if we've never understood it before, when we saw the passion of the Christ, I'm sure it brought the reality of what Jesus went through to us in a very profound way. Am I right? And I thought to myself, of course I know the story from a biblical perspective, but when I saw it in a pictorial form in the film, it was very hard to get over it. The incredible price that Jesus paid and how he survived what he did before he was crucified, because the lashing and the whipping and all that Jesus went through. Bear the fact in mind, we are speaking about God incarnate. The power that was at his disposal, but yet he chose not to draw on that. He allowed the dust that he formed from the dust of the ground. He allowed that same dust to spit in his face, mock him, taunt him, lash him, ridicule him. Okay? And he did nothing about it. So, when we talk about love, say, for God so loved, we cannot really comprehend that. The agape love of God, we can't comprehend it. No human being can really comprehend how much God loves us. Fallen, broken, nothing. But God himself divested himself, came down, allowed himself to go through that, was broken and they destroyed his body. The only reason the bones was not broken is because it was prophesied. The word of God says not one of his bones should be broken. How those bones were not broken? Simply because of the word. But yet, do not underestimate the pain, the suffering that our Lord went through. I mentioned about man's staple diet being bread and how much we rely on it. We can't survive without food, right? It's impossible. Even if you go on fasting after a few days or a few weeks, if you have the constitution to do that, you will begin to suffer. So we need food. In this case, bread. But the one who made the wheat, his body became bread. He did. So that he knew that one day you and I would be in a room with the bread typifying himself, his body. This bread in my hand is broken. I've purposely broken it in two. Because I really want to typify and understand again how much Jesus was bruised, busted, that today, me, can stand before you, before heaven, and say, I'm a child of God. Are you not happy about that? Hallelujah. Say, I'm a child of God, child of the living God, child of the living God. And devil, this is non-negotiable. Same way that Pharaoh had to let God's people go, devil, this is non-negotiable. Today, being the last day of March in our calendar, Jewish calendar, the last day of Abib, last day. You all know the importance of the last words. And the father is about to leave this world. If he has children, he will gather his children around his bedside and will say some very, very necessary things for his children to hear because of their legacy, their tomorrows. Prophesies over their lives. The last words are everything. Amen, amen, amen. It projects that child into their tomorrows. Are you listening here? Jesus on the cross, that bruised body. They offered him water, even vinegar, and he says no. His last words were when John the beloved wept over him when he saw his Messiah, the one he loved so much, on that cross. Jesus looked back at him and says, don't weep for me, weep for yourself. Your children, he says to his mother, woman, behold your son, talking about John. Son, behold your mother. there was a release, transfer. Oh God. But those were not his last words. His last words before he gave up his spirit. It's not even right to say that Jesus died, because you can't kill life. He gave up his spirit. But look at those last words. Tetelestia. It is finished. Man's redemption is paid. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. He didn't say, I am finished. He says, it is finished. My redemption is paid. Brothers and sisters, your redemption is paid. What is the hit he's talking about? The purpose. The assignment that I came down to fulfill 33 years ago. That assignment, that job, I've done it. It is done. Glory to God. How done is it? The thief on the cross, the murderer, the one who was guilty of death, looked at Jesus, and a revelation came to him. That is the Son of God. Jesus said something very strange to him. He said, today, you are going to be with me in paradise. Note what he said. It did not say, you are going to be with me in the earth. He looked beyond the grave, and he knew he was going back to his celestial palace in heaven. He said, son, look at this God. He didn't mention the man's crime that brought him to this place of death. He looked beyond it. Why? Because the blood was being shed on the cross, and the thief, the murderer, identified, connected with the blood. Jesus says, today, you are going to be with me in paradise. If God permits, next week we'll bring some thoughts back to you. But from the beginning, in the book of Exodus till today, God says, I want this to be a memorial. Not just for you, but for your children, for the next generation. What we're doing here, brothers and sisters, it's not the first time we've done it, and we're certainly not going to be, we were not the originator of this, and we're not going to be the last people to take the Lord's Supper, because it must be continual. The reason why I don't do it ritualistically every week or every month, because it will lose its meaning. Anything you do too often, or anything you have consistently, you begin to take it for granted. So whenever the Spirit of God instructs me to do the Lord's Supper, that's when I do it, because it must be impacting. It must have meaning. It costs God too much for us just to run through this without meaning. In natural fact, only believers, those who are born again, should take of the Eucharist. Is that true? So as you hold that morsel in your hands, I want you to lift it up, and I want you to just be grateful in your heart. In your heart, think about this. And in a second or two, I'll instruct you to eat of this thing, because in the same way you take up physical bread, physical food, and it sustains you. My brothers and sisters, this morsel which represents the body of our Lord Jesus, as we ingest this thing called bread, it's not even bread, just a flake, wafer, tasteless. It's meant to be tasteless. It's not meant to be sweet, enjoyable, because it represents something very untasteful. So the same night in which our Lord was betrayed, he took bread, and after he blessed it, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, said, this is my body, which is broken for you. As often as you eat of this bread, you do show the Lord's death until he comes. God bless you. In like manner also, after he had supped the cup, saying, "This is the New Testament in my blood. For as often as you eat of this bread and drink of this cup, do show the Lord's death until he comes." God bless you. Glen, just where you are. Keep on playing, guys. That's good. I pray that this will not be just a ritual for you. Certainly wasn't for me. Certainly is not. Lift up them hands. King Jesus, you paid the ultimate price that we today can have the opportunity of being called yours. We're your children. You're not just our God, but you are our big brother. You understand the pains, the grief, the suffering of your younger siblings. And you saw what awaited us. You stepped out of the high of the palace of heaven. You said, Father, I will go down. I will go down. And I'll give my life a ransom for my brothers. The word thank you so often overused. It's all we have, God. All we can say is from a grateful heart, thank you. Thank you. Paying the price that you did. Why? We don't know. Just say thank you. Lord, I pray as we take of your body, drink of your blood on this last day, this Sunday. Glory to Jesus. This month, Lord of Abib, in the same way, Father God, the clock went forward. We find ourselves an hour ahead of where we were yesterday. I pray, Father God, that you shall leap us forward. 2024, which you've impregnated me with, declaring, my God, this to be the year where we dominate. Father, I pray that the strength, the invigoration, the wherewithal that we need to dominate in 2024, we receive that today. And I declare from this desk, Lord, in this room, that this is indeed shall be the beginning of days for us. Glory be to the Redeemer. My God, I pray for every male in this room. I pray you shall lift them up. From the youngest to the oldest, I pray, Lord, you will start with the male in this room. Not because we're chauvinistic, but that's just the way you've ordained it, oh God. I pray shall anoint the men to be men of Zion. Men who can stand the test of this time. Men who can lead their families, Lord, to a place where God is. I pray for every mother, every single mother in this room. Strengthen them and be their husband. Be their provider, Father God. I pray for every single, Lord, those who are not married and may not have children, but you shall be their friend. I pray for all of us, Lord, from the oldest to the youngest in this room, Father. I pray you shall strengthen them, Father God. Let this body, Lord, let this body receive on this blood that we've drank of today, Lord. Strengthen our bodies, Father. I pray for a newness of life. I pray for a double portion of the anointing of the Holy Ghost, Lord, that can counteract and stop the works of darkness that's arrayed against us. I pray a special prayer for my churches in Kenya, Father. I lift up Pastor Ambati and Pastor Zachary in your presence. I pray for the orphanage there, Father. I pray that what they have need of you is supplied according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus. As you lift up this mother church, Father, lift them up also all the way in Kenya and do for them what only you can do, Father God. And they will not just get by, but they shall walk in abundance. As they're growing numerically, Father, may they grow in abundance and provision. Father God, the government may not sustain them, but you sustain them.
provided for that those churches over there, Father God. We thank you for you ahead of them, Lord, Father God. You've kept them all these years. Continue to be with them, Father. Provide for them. I pray, Father God, for the sick in this room. I pray for healing that will flow, Father God, from the cross into every infirm body, every diseased body. Heal, Father God. Turn around, my God, diseased body to make your children whole. Father God, that they can function to the optimum you've made them to function at. And if you'll do that, we're going to bless you. We're going to bless you. We're going to praise you, Father God. Hear my cry this morning. In Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Now, this may sound strange to you. This may sound strange to you. I need both my elders to come and stand beside me. I am feeling such burden for our male in the house. I have done for a long time. You know that. Come closer, guys. I'm going to talk a lot more about these roles that you have. Not today. But there comes a point that this battle must be fought on two fronts. I want you to come and stand right here, Ola. Right there. Levi, come and stand right here. Now don't face me, face the people, please. I need you guys to kneel down just where you are. You two men, you two, myself, kneel down. Kneel down. Kneel down.
Can do. I can have the oil, please. I want. But this is the second thing God asked me to do today. No, toasting, that was so right. I don't want to offend you. I really don't want to offend you. I don't want to do that. So we say Jesus paid the ultimate price, and he did. He paid the ultimate price. But it's so wrong. It's a fallacy to really think that Jesus did that just so you could have a nice life. He didn't. He calls you and takes the yoke of sin and the world off of your neck, but he also put another yoke on you. I assume this is God toasting, just by you just saying, plain out. Say, you lead, I'll follow. I don't know if you really understand what following Jesus really means. It doesn't mean just having a nice life at all. It's painful. It's very painful walking with God. It busts you in so many ways. knocks you down so that he can build you up. That's what he does. In this room, all the guys in this room, all you male in this room, we can start talking about the Passover. God says, can't just be any male, can't just be any male, has to be a male, the first year. Something is awfully wrong. What's happening in the church today with our men? And all I can do, all I can do is these guys us around me. They're samples. They are samples. But I want, first of all, my elders to understand great responsibility. I've tried to shield you guys all the time. You've taken this mantle, you've been ordained, so has my deacon as well. The magnitude of your call, I don't think you really understand the depth of it. When the Amalek came against Israel, these two men by Moses on the mountain, but these men, Joshua and the men in the valley, fought the battle. And as long as Moses' hands was held up, Joshua and the men in the valley prevailed. The men that's in this room, that's where you should be, in the valley fighting. I don't know if This may get a little bit out of control. What God told me this morning is I need to anoint the people in this house. He didn't say who, but I feel the need to anoint the men, call you to accountability on this very most sacred day, in my opinion, of our calendar, Christian calendar. Jesus paid an awful price. Gentlemen, young and old, you got to pay a price. You got to get committed to the house of God. It's going to cost you, but it'll be worth it. All I can do is just follow the Spirit of God right now, because God said, pray for those who gave today, and then God's anointed the church, but he didn't say who. All the men in the house, I'll start with you. You don't have to come if you want. If you don't want to, you don't have to come. But if you say, Pastor, this is my house, I'm willing to fight. I need to fight. The devil cannot win. These men represent the spiritual aspect of it. These guys have a job that maybe I failed to really tell you guys that I knew what your call involved. Same with you, deacon. What is lacking? It doesn't matter how much Joshua's hand or Moses' hand was held up by Ur and Hiram, doesn't matter. Without Joshua and the men in the valley, Israel would have lost. Every man, there's quite a few of you on the balcony. If you want to go home, you can. But if you're serious about it, I said, Pastor, you know what? This is a serious time. I need to get more involved. I need to get committed. Understand, we are cutting something here. It's a defining line. Don't do that. If they don't want to come, leave them. But this is the matter of life and death. I really believe it. Let me have the oil. Let me have the oil, please. Ade, come. Yeah. You may want to lift this up. Maybe I should qualify. I'm talking about a commitment. Oh, the guys are coming. The guys are coming. So can Levi, Ollie, you can stand up. This is probably the most significant thing I've ever done in this church. Probably. Calling you out. But understand what I'm calling you to. I'm not calling you to a nice, easy life. I'm talking to you about committing your life to Jesus and maybe even ministry. Committing your life. Look at these men, ladies. They've been hiding. My God, but God is calling you out today. Accountability. God said, are you in or are you not in? I think this is important. I want you to listen to this statement before I do this. God, this is so important what I'm doing today. Heard a young minister from Africa. I don't know which part of Africa he was speaking, but I heard him say these words, and I thought, my God. He said these words which resonated with me so much. He said, you Christians of the West, you are getting to where we in Africa have been for many years. But I don't think the majority understand. He said, for a lot of us in Africa, we've had to die for Jesus. We've had to die. But one thing we will not do, we will not allow the government or any power to deny us of our faith and our commitment to God. We will stand for God. He said, you folks in the West, you don't understand this, but there's a power coming against your faith politically, economically in the West, and you are going to have to make the same decision that some of us in Africa have made for many years. And I heard that, I thought, my God. Brothers and sisters, I start with the men again. God is not calling you to a nice, easy life on planet Earth. In actual fact, He is calling you to die to yourself, your ambitions, your passion. He wants to break you down till He can build you up again, till you can become a threat to the devil, who wants to kill the church, wants to kill your family. And it's all because the men will not stand and be counted, will not stand for the gospel, will not stand for the faith and be radical to the point where the devil and demons have to back away. Because brothers, without you, the church is weak. Sisters are glorious. I love the women in the church. They are amazing. But brothers, it is not structurally correct to just build with the strength of the female. God made you a male for a purpose. He believed in you, and He wants you to become the structure of this church, to lead your family to the place where God is.
You can't do that unless you're committed to God. I don't know. That's good. I think I need to start with my elders. I want you to understand the call of being an elder. I want you to understand you've got to get higher, Elder Nigel, and it's a spiritual accountability that's way beyond where you are right now. Lord, my God, on the mountain, Elder George, the same thing, the same thing, the same thing, the same thing. Higher place in the Spirit of God. And my God, that this church can be strong and be ready to move into the Joshua generation. Same with my deacons. In Jesus' mighty name, in Jesus' mighty name. Cannot be weak and feeble anymore. No, 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 no. The men in the valley, the men in the valley, just a touch. Allow you just a touch for the next level of your assignment in Jesus' name. Levi, just a touch for where God is taking you in the next level of your assignment. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Men, come, come. It's okay to sing it, but it's time I need to come closer, closer, closer. Chris, the men, the men, the men in the house. Men in the house, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Just a touch, man. Just a touch. 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 My God, Simon. Simon, come on. Come on. Come on, Simon. Get in. Get in right here. More of us. More. You know this. You know this. You know this. You know this. Yes, Alex. Yes, 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 yes. Just a touch, man. Just a touch. Just a touch. Just a touch. It's a touch, it's a touch. God is calling you to a place you've never been, a place you've never been. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Come in, come in. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. In Jesus' mighty name. Glory to your name, my King. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Goodness, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness, my yes, sir. God bless you. God is calling you, he's calling you to a higher place, a deeper place, a place of relationship. Jonte, yes, son. Today, today, Jonte, step over, step over, step over to God. My God, David, come, 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 come. Welcome, son. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. So what God told me to do. Anoint the people, anoint the people. Hallelujah. Follow, yes, son, yes, son, yes, son, yes, son. My God, 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 my God. Jesus, 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 team. May God heal you and deliver you to that team. Jesus, mighty name. My goodness, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness. My goodness, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, son, yes, son, yes, son, yes, son. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Yes, sir. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Diba koto shakri bai. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. My goodness, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness. My goodness, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Are they? Jesus, my God, Jesus, my God, Jesus, my God, Jesus, my God. Hallelujah. Yes, Tosin, yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'll come to you. Hallelujah. I have to ask you again. I'll have to ask you again. I want to ask you again. As I was walking across this floor, all the men that I just anointed, quickly, just come back out here. All of you. All of you. All of you. Just come quickly, quickly. Just come quickly. Jesus. If you've got to come up here, come up here, come up here. Come on, Aaron, come, come. Come, look at these young men. Look at these amazing young men. Middle-aged, old men. Look at this. Come up, Elder. Come up. Come up. Come up. Come up. Come up. Come, leave. Come up here. Come up. Come, come, come.
Lord, my God. Come up. Come up. Come up. Oh, Jesus. Lord Jesus. Come, John, step up. Come up. All of you. All of you. Come. Come. My God. My God. So I can lay out here now. All of us come out right out here. Come out here. All the men come across here. Stay there. You know, look at that. Look at this. All of this is going across the world. But I didn't bring you up here to embarrass you. I didn't bring you there to embarrass you at all. The world is seeing you, but you know what? The reason why I called you up? This, brothers, is what hell is afraid of. You. And I was walking across there. God says, if only 10% of these men get radical, the war is over. We'll wreck Milton Keynes. Only 10%. The reason you hide and do what you do and stay in the background is because the devil's putting you that you can do your own thing and be successful without God. You are mistaken. Brothers, this will be immortalized. Today is like no other day. Hell has been notified that there are men in Faith Dimensions Church. His greatest fear is you. It's you. Who are the men? Who are the Joshuas, the Calebs, the Aarons? Who are they? 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 Goes way, way beyond your ambitions, gentlemen. There's a call of God on your life which requires sacrifice, pain, but it's worth it. Ladies, please give the men a big blessing. Oh, you need to come down. Come down. Thank you, guys. But remember today. Remember, Stephen, today. Hallelujah. Today. Today. All the... forgetting you. No way. No way. I just felt God saying, I should do this. The ladies that's in the house, you know who you are. I know some of you. Incredible gifting. Incredible support. Ladies, the anointing that's placed on the men today is for you too. Glory to God. Yeah. You're right. Faith, come. Come, Gloria. Abby, come. All the ladies who know that God has called you to a higher place and you're willing to fight. You're willing to fight. Commit unreservedly to God. Faith, this is real. This is real. This is real. Hallelujah. Abby, it's real. It's real. It's real. It's real. The call of God is real. Luke. It's real, baby. It's real. It's real. It's real. It's real.
Gloria, it's real. My God, it's so real, Gloria. It is so big. Lord Jesus, come at me. Come, come. Come. Come, ribs. Come, come, come. Ladies, if you want this, come. We're going to do some things for God in this planet. My God, Phoebe, come, 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 come. Mary, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Steph, so real, so real, so real. I'm saying Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. My God, Sash, come, come, come. Hallelujah. Oh, no, so real, so real, so real. Jesus, my God, my God, my God, my God, my God. Yes, Emma, yes, Emma, yes, Emma. My God, Judith. Jesus. So real, so real, so real, my God. For me, yes, for me, yes, for me, yes, for me, yes, for me, shine. Yes, ma'am, it's real, it's real, it's real. Lady of Zion, Lady of Zion, call you to a deeper place. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Door by your door, by your door, my God, my God, my God. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. God bless you, God bless you. Young lady, loves you, loves you. He's got a plan for your life. Anointing of God on your life. Yes, Rosemary, in Jesus' name. Yes, Jesus, yes, Jesus. Yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am. Jesus, my King, Jesus, my King, Jesus, my King. Thank you, Lord, 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 thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Steph, today, 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 a bigger commitment, a deeper place. Hallelujah. Only today, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Just a touch, anointing, a covering, my God, a preparation for greatness. Help me, Jesus. Glory of God, my goodness, my goodness, my goodness. In Jesus' name, yes, Jesus, yes, 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 yes. Jesus Christ, my God, my God, my God, my God, Jesus. Yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. My God. Thank you, Lord, yes, 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 yes. My goodness, my goodness, my goodness, yes. Jesus, Jesus. Oh, Lord, it's real, it's real, it's real, it's real. Jesus, my God, come, come. Jesus, my God, Joseph. Bless you, God bless you.